Your vehicle may be equipped with our convenient HomeLink system. HomeLink replaces up to 3 remote controls or handheld transmitters so you can operate devices such as garage door openers, motorized gates, lighting, or home security systems from the safety of your driver's seat. You'll find the HomeLink buttons in the overhead console. To start programming for a garage door opener, first, make sure you're parked outside the garage. It's also recommended that you put new batteries in the handheld device you'll be programming. The HomeLink unit is powered by the vehicle's battery and does not require replacement. Then you'll want to reset the HomeLink system memory. To do this, simply push and hold the 2 outside buttons until you see Channels Cleared in the instrument cluster. This could take up to 20 seconds. This procedure erases all 3 HomeLink button programs, so you only need to do it once. Do not erase all 3 channels when programming additional buttons. Now, before you program your HomeLink system, you'll need to determine the type of garage door opener you have. Go to the garage door opener motor in the garage. See if you can find the Learn or Train button, which is usually found where the hanging antenna wire connects to the garage door opener motor. It is not the same button normally used to open and close the door, and it may vary by name or color depending on the manufacturer. If you can find a Learn or Train button on the opener motor, then you're using a newer rolling code garage door opener, and programming will involve a few additional steps. If there is no Learn or Train button, that means you have an older, non-rolling code garage door opener. Once you know what type of opener you're using, you're now ready to program the HomeLink system. Here we go. Put the ignition into the on-run position and hold the battery's side of your handheld transmitter away from the HomeLink button you wish to program. Place the handheld transmitter 1 to 3 inches or 3 to 8 centimeters away from the HomeLink button while keeping the instrument cluster display in view. Now, simultaneously push and hold both the chosen HomeLink button and the handheld transmitter button until the instrument cluster display changes from channel training to channel trained. When it does, release both buttons. The garage door may open and close while you're programming. To check your programming, push and hold the Just Program HomeLink button. If the instrument cluster displays channel transmit, then programming is complete. The garage door should now activate when the HomeLink button is pushed. At this point, if you have an older, non-rolling code garage door opener, you're done. Your HomeLink controls and garage door opener should now be in sync, and you'll see channel transmit displayed in the instrument cluster. If you have a rolling code garage door opener, here's where those additional steps come into play. Go to the garage door opener and once again, find the Learn or Train button. Firmly push and release it. You now have 30 seconds to return to the HomeLink system, so move quickly. Better yet, it might be good to have a second person standing by at the HomeLink system. Once there, push the HomeLink button you'd like to program twice. Hold the button for 2 seconds each time. If the opener is plugged in and activates, programming is complete. If it does not activate, push the button a third time for 2 seconds to complete the training. Please note that HomeLink will be disabled anytime an onboard security alarm is active. If you have any problems or require assistance, please call toll-free 1-800-355-3515 or visit homelink.com for information or assistance. This video is not intended to take the place of your owner's manual. For complete details and other important safety information, please see your owner's information.